Okay, at the last part of chapter 2, let's study an application of linked list. Polynomials addition. First representation of a polynomial. Usually, a polynomial can be expressed with this expression. In this expression, pi is non-zero coefficient for each item, and it is in ascending shorted order by exponent. Exponent vary from 0 to n. For such a polynomial, it can be represented with a list and its contiguous representation or singly linked representation. Size of the list is n plus 1. But for a sparse polynomial, for example, most of the items in the polynomials are 0. It has only 3 non-zero items. Then, use the representation we have just discussed. Most of the elements are 0. It will result in waste of memory space. For such a sparse polynomial, it can be expressed in this way. We only represent its non-zero items, and pi is non-zero coefficient, and exponent are in ascending order. Then we can define a list. Each item, each element has 2 data items. And then we can use such a singly linked list to represent a sparse polynomial. In this representation, each node, its data field has 2 members or 2 items. Let's have a look at its implementation. Here, we have to redefine element type. For each element, it has 2 data items. One is for its coefficient. One is for its exponent. The node definition in this linked list is just the same. We only have to redefine element type. And then we can define operations operate on the list. For example, how to create a sparse polynomial, destroy, output, or add 2 polynomials. Because time permits, in class, we only discuss how to add or how to calculate sum of 2 sparse polynomials. For example, we are given 2 polynomials and design an algorithm to calculate its sum. Suppose all the polynomials are represented in a singly linked list. For each node in the list, it has its data field has 2 items. One is for coefficient and one is for exponent. They are appeared in ascending order of exponents. It doesn't matter how we draw the node, it's just a conceptual view of the list. To add 2 polynomials, the first method is to create a new singly linked list to hold elements in the sum of polynomials. So first, create a header node and its next pointer assign now. And then we declare variables points to first node in head A and head B respectively. And then for the new singly linked list, we declare a pointer. QC always points to the tail of the new list. Initially, it points to the header. And then compare the node QA points to and QB points to. Copy the smaller one's data field and generate a new node and insert at the tail. So this algorithm or this method is an application of create a singly linked list each time insert a new node at the tail. Compare QA's exponent and QB's exponent. QA is smaller, so generate a new node, copy QA's data field, and then insert at tail. How to insert at tail? QC's next points to the new node, suppose it's S, and then QC and QA moves forward. Compare again. This time, they have the same exponent. We have to calculate the sum of coefficients. If the sum is not zero, then we generate a new node. The coefficient is sum of QB's coefficient and QA's coefficient. And then insert at tail. QC's next points to the new node. QC, QB, and QA moves forward together. Next time, QB's coefficient is smaller. Copy QB's data field and insert at tail. Next case, they have the same exponent and the sum of coefficients is zero. Then no need to generate a new node. QA and QB moves forward together. Repeat until either QA or QB reach the end of the list. In our example, we can see QB reached the tail first, so no need to compare. Copy the rest nodes in QA and each time insert it at tail of QC. Until QA reach the tail, the algorithm finish. Actually, this is the application of each time insert a new node at the tail. And let's summarize its operation rules. Define two variables QA and QB. Let them point to nodes in list A and list B respectively. Initially, QA and QB points to the first node. Compare their exponents. We have three different branches. And each time, copy the data field of the smaller one. If they have same value of exponents, we have to calculate sum of their coefficient. And also, if the sum of coefficient is zero, QA and QB moves forward together. Don't need to generate a new node. Otherwise, generate a new node and the coefficient is sum of QA, QB's coefficients. Until QA reach the tail or QB reach the tail, and then copy the remaining nodes. The whole algorithm finish. I think this algorithm is not very difficult for you to write. You can write it by yourself. To add two polynomials, let's see another method. The second method is to modify list LA. Insert or delete some nodes in head A. And finally, in this list, it starts the sum of two polynomials. Actually, it's an application of insertion and deletion operation of singly linked list. Let's have a look at this scheme. First, we declare four pointers. Why we define four pointers? Because singly linked list is a kind of one-way structure. So HA always points to the node of QA's predecessor. Similarly, pointer HB always points to the node prior to QB. Initially, HA points to head A, QA points to the first node in list A, and similarly, HB points head node of second list, and QB points to the first node in list B. Each time we compare exponent of QA points to and QB points to, the first case, the node QA points to has smaller exponents. That means the node QA points to is one item of the sum. So in this case, HA and QA moves forward together. How to move these two pointers together? We can use these two statements. Assign QA to HA, and then QA points to its next. Repeat, compare exponents of QA and QB. This time, they have equal exponents. Under such circumstance, we have to calculate sum of coefficient of QA and QB. If the coefficient sum is not zero, then we can determine there is an item in sum of two polynomials. Its exponent is one, and we have to modify QA's coefficient. Modify its coefficient to sum of these two, and then HA and QA moves forward together. How to move both these two pointers together? HA points to QA, and QA points to next. At the same time, QB should be deleted from the list. In a singly linked list, how to delete a node? We have to modify its predecessor's next field. So modify HB's next, let it point to QB's next, and then free QB, and then QB moves to its successor, and the statement is QB is assigned with HA's next. This is the second case. If they have equal exponents and the sum of coefficients is not zero. Let's repeat again. This time, the exponent QA points to is smaller. Then what should be done? First, we have to delete QB from this list, and then insert QB between HA and QA. Let's finish these operations one by one. First, delete QB from head B. HB's next points to QB's next, and then insert QB between HA and QA. Two pointers to be modified. QB's next points to QA, H is next, point to QB. Any other things to do? Yes, currently QB is predecessor of QA, so HA should point to QB. HA points to QB, and QB points to HB's next. So far, this case has been completed. And repeat again. Compare their exponents. We can see they have same exponents. And similarly, calculate the sum of coefficients. This time, its coefficient sum is zero. Then these two nodes, QA.2 and QB.2, should be freed, released from the list. How to delete a node QA.2 and QB.2? We have to modify its predecessor's next field. First, delete QA. HA's next points to QA's next, and then free QA. QA moves forward. QA points to HA's next. Okay, this node has been deleted, and now let's delete node QB points to HB's next points to QB's next, and then free QB, and then QB points to HB's next. It's a null pointer. So the operation will be repeated until QA reach the tail first or QB reach the tail first. In this case, in our example, QB reached the tail first. Actually, there is only one thing left to do. Free head node of head B and the algorithm finish. Another situation, if QA reached the tail first, then the left elements in QB should be linked at the tail of QA. So if QB is not zero, means QA reach the tail first, one element to link the left elements in QB, and then head node of list B should be freed, and algorithm finish. Let's redraw the linked list. After this algorithm has been executed, head B stored all the items in sum of two polynomials, and useless nodes has been freed. This is the second method of adding two polynomials. We can write the algorithm, no return value, head A will be changed, also head B will also be changed, so we use reference parameter. Initialize four pointers, and then while QA and QB not reach the tail, continue the while loop. Each time we compare their coefficient. We have three branches. If either QA is null or QB is null, break out from the loop and check. If QB is not reached the tail, then link the remain nodes to HA, free the head node. And for these three branches, the first one is the easiest. HA and QA moves forward. And the second one, we have discussed this, what should be done. And the third one, we have to calculate sum of coefficient. And also, we have two branches. If the coefficient sum is zero, what should to do? And what if it's not zero? These two elements should be done. And time complexity for this algorithm. Worst the case, it will deal with all the elements in head A and head B. So time complexity is linear to m plus n. Okay, so much for this chapter.